I'm Quinn DelHoyo. I'm the multiplayer designer on Gears of War Judgment.
So let's talk a little about what your goals were heading into multiplayer for Judgment.
Goals were to simplify, look at the trilogy that was there before, and to take what was there, what was a little too clunky, and to simplify it down. A lot of that was the control scheme, make that really good, fast, and streamlined, which goes into our other big mode, which, or not the mode, but the mission that we have, is make it fast-paced, make the game feel more free, or freer, I should say. And so along those lines, we're moving the clunkiness of the frustration of sometimes players can blame the game, but so that you have the control scheme, Y is a quick weapon switch, left bumper is the offhand grenades. That was right there probably one of the biggest bold moves that we went with when we were developing this game, was the changing of the control scheme.
When it comes to eSports, that's really grown over the last few years. How did that influence you guys when you were creating the multiplayer?
I'm a big fan of eSports. There's a few people here at Epic Games that are as well. And when it comes to anything at sports, I mean, I was a football coach. I love sports. All of that competition. And looking at, when you look at Overrun, which is our competitive class-based multiplayer mode, it has actually influences of it from MOBA games like League of Legends and Dota, where you know you have a map and there's three lanes on those games. Where in our game, we decided let's have two lanes and all the Overrun maps. So you have a left and you have a right to make the combat focused and intense and fast-paced. And that was one of the influences that we had in making the game was, and those are really popular in esports. And in my opinion, Overrun is very easy to watch from a spectator because it's third-person camera. You can see who the player is controlling. And with the monsters that are in Overrun, like the Locust and all the other classes that are easily defined, someone that's even commentating or casting could actually easily hypothesize, oh, this guy is a boomer or a mauler, and this is what he can kind of do. This is his abilities. And he's got a Kantas coming behind him, and you can kind of predict what is going to happen. And that builds the drama and the intensity that people that watch sports or esports would really enjoy.
Do you feel that this mode could work when it comes to a professional game? We have a lot of leagues out there that are always looking for new games.
Most definitely. I really do. I am really excited about Overrun. We've made it very simple. And that's not to say it's shallow. It's very simple. It's very easy to understand. And that, to me, that's very important for anything. If I want my grandma to watch a football game with me or my wife to watch basketball, it needs to be somewhat simple, right? And I definitely think Overrun is something that people could use at an eSport level.
And when it comes to Overrun, let's talk a little about the map you guys are showing here, the junkyard, and also explain the multi-tiered objectives that we'll play through during the course of the match.
Right, yeah, so Junkyard is kind of a mix between an interior and an exterior map. And it takes place in a factory industrial type of junkyard area. And there's two lanes, like we mentioned before. There's a left lane and a right lane. And how that has kind of played out through development is we make a bunch of maps, and Junkyard was one of the ones that kind of came through pretty quickly because it was very simple and easy to understand. So the multi-tiered objectives that we have in Overrun are very simple. You have the attackers, which are the Locust team. They try to get what we're calling the E-hole cover, or E-hole, or emergence hole for short, right? That's where the Locusts come out of if we're talking about fiction in Gears of War. So the Locust team are trying to destroy this cover that the COG have put over this hole to keep them from coming out. So they try to take that over, and then once they take that over, the map gets pushed, the COG gets pushed back, and then the map opens up new areas. So the maps are kind of big and Overrun, and long, I should say, but each play space is really tight that you actually can find a plan. And so once you get the first objective, you move to the next area, which is that objective. And that is another E-hole cover. So there's two E-hole covers, and the final objective is a generator. And that is the COG at their last stand, and they're holding out to keep the Locust from destroying the generator. And then they destroy the generator, and that's how they get their points. And so each objective is worth 1 point, 3 points total. And if both teams happen to get all three objectives, then it comes down to time. So you always want to go as fast as you can. It's very fast paced.
And when it comes to the other mode you guys are showing, Free For All, talk about how that came from actually the fans playing kind of on their own.
Yeah, so for Free For All, we have, it's very simple. It's something you find in other games, but in Gears of War, we've never had it. You know, it's always been a team-based game. And the fans and in communities, especially in the competitive communities, we've talked about eSports, the competitive Gears players, in order to warm up before their matches or even online, if you wanted to be really good and practice your own skill, you get a bunch of your friends, you go into King of the Hill and you turn on Friendly Fire and you just go and you blast each other and get really good at your movement and your shotgun and your Lancer skills. And so for this, we have it all just built into the game. You want to play free-for-all, you can do that. You don't need to do any type of weird game rule manipulation, and if none of your friends are online, that's the best part about it. It's like, hey, my team is online, so I can go and I can play free-for-all, and I don't need to worry about it.
And the map you guys are showing?
Yeah, and the map we have here is called Streets, and for free-for-all, it's a really cool map. It's got a very distinct call-outs, and that's something that we've held very important as well. So for accessibility of people to learning the map, we've got a butcher shop, we've got a body shop, we've got a steelworks area, we've got a bookstore, we've got a rooftop with a water tower, and it's all, you know, streets of this area in Hallow Bay, this industrial area.